Structural markup describes the purpose of text and lets the appearance be decided by the browser. We can structure text as a header using one of the 6 header tags, with H1 being the largest and H6 the smallest. We can also align the header with the values left, right, center, or justified. Other common content-based styles are emphasis and strong emphasis. They will typically be rendered the same as italic and bold. Insert and delete are used to mark up replacement text. They are typically rendered as strikethrough and underline. When including a quotation, we have several choices available. The inline quote tag Q is intended for short quotes. However, since not all browsers render the double quotes, it's usually better to just use normal quotes instead. For longer quotations, we have block quote, which will indent the text. Then there is the cite element, which is used for citations or quote references. Both quote elements may also use the attribute named cite to provide a reference, but the value of this attribute will not be displayed on the page. Next, we have 3 elements useful in technical documents and 4 more related to programming. The technical ones are definition, abbreviation, and acronym. The generic title attribute can be useful here to enter the full name for an abbreviation or acronym. Lastly, we have the elements relating to programming. Code can be used to structure programming code. Sample to show output from a program. Keyboard for text to be entered by the user. And variable for program variable names.